Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala s-salat, hayya 'ala al-falah. Qad qamat s-salat. قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا تراصوا واعتدلوا لا تختلفوا فتختلف قلوبكم. إن شاء الله تعالى نتابع القراءة برواية شعبة رحمه الله من فاتحة يونس عليه الصلاة والسلام. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ألف كتاب الحكيم أكان للناس عجبا أن أوحينا إلى رجل منهم أن أنذر الناس وبشر الذين آمنوا أن لهم قدم صدق عند ربهم قال الكافرون إن هذا لساحر مبين إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش يدبر الأمر ما من شفيع إلا من بعد إذنه ذلكم الله ربكم فاعبدوه أفلا تذكرون إليه مرجعكم جميعا وعد الله حقا إنه يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده ليجزي الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات بالقسط والذين كفروا لهم شراب من حميم وعذاب أليم بما كانوا يكفرون هو الذي جعل الشمس ضياء والقمر نورا وقدره منازل لتعلموا عدد السنين والحساب ما خلق الله ذلك إلا بالحق نفصل الآيات لقوم يعلمون إن في اختلاف الليل والنهار وما خلق الله في السماوات والأرض لآيات لقوم يتقون إن الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا ورضوا بالحياة الدنيا واطمأنوا بها والذين هم عن آياتنا غافلون أولئك مأواهم النار بما كانوا يكسبون إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات يهديهم ربهم بإيمانهم تجري من تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين ولو يعجل الله للناس الشر استعجالهم بالخير لقضي إليهم أجلهم فنذر الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا في طغيانهم يعمهون وإذا مس الإنسان الضر دعانا لجنبه أو قاعدا أو قائما فلما كشفنا عنه ضره مر كأن لم يدعنا إلى ضر مسه كذلك زين للمسرفين ما كانوا يعملون ولقد أهلكنا القرون من قبلكم لما ظلموا وجاءتهم رسلهم بالبينات وما كانوا ليؤمنوا كذلك نجزي القوم المجرمين ثم جعلناكم خلائف في الأرض من بعدهم لننظر كيف تعملون وإذا تتلى عليهم آياتنا بينات قال الذين لا يرجون لقاء نأتي بقرآن غير هذا أو بدله قل ما يكون لي أن أبدله من تلقاء أتبع إلا ما يوحى إلي إني أخاف إن عصيت ربي عذاب يوم عظيم قل لو شاء الله ما تلوته عليكم قل لو شاء ما تلوته عليكم ولا أدريكم به فقد لبثت فيكم عمرا من قبله أفلا تعقلون فمن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا أو كذب بآياته إنه لا يفلح المجرمون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. ويعبدون من دون الله ما لا يضرهم ولا ينفعهم ويقولون هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله، قل أتنبئون الله بما لا يعلم في السماوات ولا في الأرض، سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. وما كان الناس إلا أمة واحدة فاختلفوا، ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك لقضي بينهم فيما فيه يختلفون. ويقولون لولا أنزل عليه آية من ربه، فقل إنما الغيب لله فانتظروا إني معكم من المنتظرين. وإذا أذقنا الناس رحمة من بعد ضراء مستهم إذا لهم مكر في آياتنا، قل الله أسرع مكرا، إن رسلنا يكتبون ما تمكرون. هو الذي يسيركم في البر والبحر، حتى إذا كنتم في الفلك وجرين بهم بريح طيبة وفرحوا بها جاءتها ريح عاصف وجاءهم الموج من كل مكان وظنوا أنهم أحيط بهم، دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين لئن أنجيتنا من هذه لنكونن من الشاكرين. فلما يبغون في الأرض بغير الحق، يا أيها الناس إنما بغيكم على أنفسكم، متاع الحياة الدنيا، ثم إلينا مرجعكم فننبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. إنما مثل الحياة الدنيا كماء أنزلناه من السماء فاختلق به نبات الأرض مما يأكل الناس والأنعام حتى إذا أخذت الأرض زخرفها وزينت وظن أهلها أنهم قادرون عليها أتاها أمرنا ليلا أو نهارا فجعلناها حصيدا كأن لم تغن بالأمس كذلك نفصل الآيات لقوم يتفكرون والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, we'll begin in a minute. Just looking for my earphone. And as usual, when you keep the earphone in your pocket, it gets tangled. So I wish one day somebody would come up with a new invention where we can avoid this tangling matter. Yep, working. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Can you guys hear me? Can you all hear me? Alaykum as-salam. Layla, inshallah. Would you please confirm if you can hear me? Well, I would just assume that you can hear me, actually. Alaykum as-salam.
My daughter, husband, from UK.
How are you? How are you? Good to see you. Oh, okay. Barakallah. We're live, actually, now.
Okay.
Barakallah. Good to see you. Alaykum as-salam. Okay. I just happen to have some people from the UK. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبيه ومصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وبعد, I bet you guys enjoyed the Fajr prayer and the recitation, correct? Okay, who may know which surah the Sheikh was reciting? Yeah, because I'm still in the masjid, so I have to speak kind of quiet. I'll try to raise my voice, inshallah. Today, Sheikh Abd al-Khaliq, mashallah, was leading the prayer, and he was reciting Surah Yunus from the beginning. Perfect. Abdullah Garib, mashallah, Surah Yunus. And Surah Yunus, as you know, is chapter number 10 in the Quran. And and it's a Makki surah. But if you may remember, in the beginning, he recited Alif Lam Re. Alif Lam Re, which is one of the dialects. Okay, so he was reciting according to Shu'bah. May Allah have mercy on him. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Bismillah. So he is reciting Surah Yunus from the beginning. And let me shed some light on this beautiful surah. It's named after Prophet Yunus alayhi salam. Yunus ibn Matta, who was sent in the Nineveh in Iraq. And he's a prophet who is known as the prophet of the whale. When at one point he gave up on his people and he thought that they're not gonna believe and Allah will punish them. So he just took a boat and he sailed away. And as a result, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him. So, you know, there was like a state of unrest on the boat. And they were afraid that they would be drowned. So they decided to get rid of some weight. And basically, they drew lots as whom to throw in the water. And they ended up throwing Prophet Yunus, peace be upon him. And when he was thrown in the water, فَنَادَ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبِحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مُلَطَنًا. So he called upon Allah in the darkness of the sea, in the darkness of the night, and in the darkness of the abdomen of the whale. And this dua is highly recommended in case of necessity, if somebody is in trouble, if somebody is in need, that they should call upon Allah the Almighty by saying, La ilaha illa anta subhanak. La ilaha illa anta subhanak. There is no God but you, glory be to you. Indeed, I am one of the wrongdoers. So by saying this supplication, the person, Allah the Almighty, will deliver a relief. The surah began with a demonstrative pronoun, where the Almighty Allah says, Tilka ayatul kitab al-hakim. Tilka ayatul kitab al-hakim. And we said the word tilka is a demonstrative pronoun, but in Arabic, tilka is like in English where you say that, referring to far away object, to far objects. Like, you know, let me see if you can see this. Somebody was sitting right in front of me, right in front of the camera, would say this, this, or hadihi for feminine, hada for masculine, this for feminine, okay? And if it is far away object, we say ذَلِكَ. Like somebody by the door of the masjid will say ذَلِكَ, far away. Somebody who is close or something that is close will say هَذَا. For feminine we say هَذِهِ, for nearby objects, and تِلْكَ, for far away objects. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to the ayat, the verses of the Quran, using the far away demonstrative pronoun. The far away demonstrative pronoun. Why is that? Even though the Quran is in our hands and its verses are being recited by us, but it's far away in its highness because it is coming from Allah. That's why Allah have used the demonstrative pronoun tilka, not hadihi, referring to its highness and its greatness. Tilka ayatul kitab al-hakim. These are the verses of the wise book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the Quran as a wise book. What is wise and what does it mean? We know that Al-Quran is Kalamullah, is the word of Allah. He said it, he spoke it out. So what do you expect from the all-wise to say other than what is wise? In another ayah he says, لَا يَأْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَلَا مِنْ خَلْفِهِ. Falsehood and vain doesn't approach it from any direction because it is simply the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it must be, since it is the word of the most wise, it must be all wise. Then the following verse, Allah the Almighty says, أَكَانَ لِلنَّاسِ عَجَبًا أَنْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ رَجُلٍ مِّنْهُمْ أَنْ أَنْذِرِ النَّاسَ وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنَّ لَهُمْ قَدَمَ صَدِقٍ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ قَالَ الْكَافِرُونَ إِنَّ هَذَا لَسَاحِرٌ مُّبِينٌ. And that means, have the people been amazed that we revealed the Quran and the Wahy to a man among them? And they said that how come Allah have revealed to a human being? If Allah is true, He wouldn't reveal to a human being. He should have sent an angel, right? Not a human being like us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that He have sent a man saying, warn mankind and give good tidings to those who believe that they will have a firm precedence of honor with their Lord. A firm precedence of honor with the Lord. قَدَمَ صَدِقٍ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. So the non-believers, beginning with the disbelievers of Mecca, they said, إِنَّ هَذَا لَسَاحِرٌ مُّبِينٌ. They said, this is none but a clever sorcerer, a plain magician. We know that the Meccans have experienced Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam for how many years before the prophethood? For 40 years. 40 years the age which normally the Almighty Allah appoints the prophets to be sent at this age, whether Prophet Muhammad or most of the prophets before him. So people were amazed and they said, oh, thank you, Jazakallah khairan, barakallah fi, ahsanallahu ilayk, salam, Jazakallah khairan, Jazakallah khairan, mashallah. I just got a gift. I believe it is. That's Anis. Beautiful, mashallah. It's good to drink something healthy and to slow down on the caffeine. So, as Allah sent all the prophets before Muhammad, whether Hud, Saleh, or Prophet Yunus, Ibn Matta, or, they were all human beings, okay? And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala handled the objection of the Meccan pagans, how come Allah sent a human being, he should have sent an angel? He said, وَلَوْ جَعَلْنَاهُ مَلَكًا لَجَعَلْنَاهُ رَجُلًا وَلَا لَبَسْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مَا يَلْبِسُونَ. Imagine if Allah the Almighty have sent an angel to us, what will happen? Let me explain to you once again. This is the front camera, so it flips the objects backward. So what do you read here? What do you read? You read it backward or forward? Okay, you guys keep yourselves busy with the right hand, with the left hand. Do you think that, mashallah, I would ever drink with the left hand while capable to drink with the right hand? May Allah enable all of us to use both hands. But this is what? Backward. Which means, this is my right hand. And look at the earpiece. This is normally on the right ear. Okay? But you're going to see it on the left hand, on the left side. Because the front camera flips the objects backward. Okay. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you know, When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw Angel Gabriel in his genuine form, what happened to him? He said, I saw him with 600 wings. And when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw Angel Gabriel, he collapsed. He fell unconscious. He just couldn't take it. I want you to imagine seeing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, seeing an angel in the horizon blocking the view. You can see the sun, you can see the moon. There is a major eclipse. And then you see an angel spreading his wings. And this angel would say anything. Definitely all human beings, all people would bow down in obedience and would say, yes, we obey. Correct? So what is the point of giving us the free choice? Saying believe or don't believe, that's your choice. And on the other hand, forcing us to believe. You get it? So Allah said, if he were to send a human being, if he were to send an angel, he would again make him look like a human being. How Angel Gabriel used to come to Prophet Muhammad, most of the time as a human being. Okay? In an image of a very handsome person. Yet, only when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam demanded and insisted, I want to see you, I want to see you. Okay, so Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given what he asked for, but he couldn't take it. He collapsed. So the Meccans said, they were amazed, they objected, they said, this is weird, this is bizarre. How can a human being like us be a prophet? As for why they call him Sahir Mubin, Sahir, sorcerer. Because they've tried a lot of things, and the upcoming information, it's okay. Perhaps if I drink again, somebody else would say, Bismillah. Allah, Allah, mashallah, la quwwata illa billah. The upcoming information is really important, brothers and sisters. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was already known to the Meccans. He wasn't like a new person or he landed from the sky with a parachute. No, he's somebody who's very well known. What did they call him? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sadiq and Amin. Who called him that? It was Abu Jahl, it was Abu Sufyan, it was Itab ibn Usayd, it was the Meccan people who called him Sadiq al-Amin. And you all know the story when they differed with regards to who shall put the black stone in its corner, and they were fighting. They all agreed to the judgment of whom? Of this young man, Muhammad, who was only 35 years old, correct? May Allah give you Shifa bint Sahar and all of us. Allahumma Ameen. So they already knew him. They said, well, when he recited upon them an amazing Quran, immediately without thinking, they said, he's a poet, Sha'ir. Oh, but they just realized that this man never ever read or write a thing. And some people, unfortunately, among Muslims, they circulate a message on the WhatsApp, on their social media, saying that, oh no, don't you say Prophet Muhammad was illiterate or unliterate. Prophet Muhammad was very knowledgeable and he read and he wrote 70 different languages. Habibi, that is not going to make Prophet Muhammad any greater or any better when you lie and when you ascribe something to him that it wasn't his. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him as Ummi. Then you would find somebody who doesn't know Arabic, who doesn't know the Quran, and say the word Ummi means for Mecca. Oh, really? Really? But Ali was not Ummi. Uthman was not Ummi. They read, they wrote, they were able to read, but they were not called Ummi. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it very clear when he said, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ إِذًا لَرْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. It's as simple as that. Before the prophethood and after, you're not able to write down nor read. You know, if you were able to read or write, the falsifier would have accused you that you have wrote it down, you have made it up. But in fact, he wasn't able to read, he wasn't able to write. And this is a quality in the case of Prophet Muhammad, even though it's a dispraise when it comes to any other human being. But exclusively for Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, it's a quality and it's a praiseworthy quality. Why that? Because he wasn't taught by any human being, he was taught by Allah. So even though what he brought was so amazing, as we all know that he wasn't able to read nor to write, so that refuted the misconception and the false accusation of the Meccan who said that, oh, he copied it from other books or he made it up because he's a good poet. No, he wasn't a good poet. He doesn't know how to phrase poetry. Okay? So this is really important. So they shifted after they said that he is a poet. He made it up or he copied it from other books. They turned around to say, well, you know that he's illiterate. So they came up with another accusation, false accusation, where they said that he's a sorcerer. He's a magician. Similar to what the Pharaoh accused Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, with. Now, in ayah number 3, and most likely, inshallah, we'll wrap it up with ayah number 3. Maybe inshallah look into your questions if you have any questions. And number 3. Inna rabbakumullahu alladhi khalaqa as-samawati wal-arda fi sittati ayyamin thumma istawa 'ala al-'arsh yudabbiru al-amra ma min shafi'in illa min ba'di idhnihi dhalikumullahu rabbukum fa'budu afala tadhakkarun. What do we have here? We have a magnificent ayah. As I said, inshallah, I will wrap it up with this ayah. And I just wanted to get your feedback. If you think that broadcast today was useful and was interesting as well, listening to the recitation of Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, then following that by shedding some light on the ayat or some of the ayat which were recited, please let me know, and inshallah Azza Jal will try to do this more often. Okay? And don't forget to tell me where you're watching from. I will appreciate that. Bismillah. So the Almighty Allah says in the third ayah of Surah Yunus, indeed, your Lord is Allah, the one who created the heavens and the earth, as-samawati wal-arb, in how many days? In 6 days. In how many days? In 6 days. The Jews and the Christians said that, yeah, he created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, then he did what? Then he rested on the seventh. Ma'ad Allah, may Allah forgive us our sins. You know, Allah is above what they ascribe to him. He never rested because he doesn't need to rest. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. Neither a slumber nor a sleep overtake him. He's always awake. He doesn't experience any fatigue. And Noor Zaland, I love you too for the sake of Allah. So after, I don't know what to do with my beard. Huh? How is it now? How is the sound now? Maybe inshallah I will get another shukran ma'i. Thank you. Jazakallah khair. People are very nice here. Everybody is offering a drink, mashallah. Wallahi, the Muslim Ummah is very beautiful. Except for the fact that we've been tested by some people who are controlling us. Unfortunately, trying to direct us to the wrong way. Now, some people are complaining that it said the mic touched my beard. So, how is that? I will keep holding it. So, the ayah says Allah created the heavens and the earth in 6 days. Then what? Then he rose above the throne. He rose above the throne. That answers a lot of questions. And you know, in many places in the Quran, at least 6 places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirmed that he's above his throne, he rose above the throne. So it's very simple. When your child asks you, where is Allah? Where do you say? What do you say? He's above his throne. Isn't this answer satisfactory? Well, this is what Allah said. إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Then he rose above the throne. Where is the throne? The throne is above the seventh heaven. And we have learned that in the journey of the Mi'raj, Isra and Mi'raj. And in Jannah, the ceiling, the roof of heaven will be the arsh of the most beneficent. يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرِ. He runs the affairs of what? Of whom? Of every living creature. يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرِ. Of every living creature. You see, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. There is not a single living creature, but its provision is with Allah. An ant, a microorganism, bacteria, you name it. All the living creatures are provided by whom? By Allah, not by anyone else, not even by the angels. So يدبر الأمر or not, runs the affairs or not, takes care of the needs of his creatures or not. Yes, indeed. Then he said, وَمَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ وَلَا رَطْبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. You want to know how Allah runs affairs and He is fully in charge and He's fully aware? Listen to this. Not a single leaflet that falls from a tree, but He's aware of it. Not a single seed that is sown under the ground, but it is written in a book, He's fully aware of it. Subhanallah. So يدبر الأمر. ما من شفيع إلا من بعد إذنه. There is no way that anyone can intercede before him without his leave. Where did we hear this? Also, we heard that in Surah Al-Anbiya, وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنِ ارْتَضَى. They do not intercede for anyone, but for those whom Allah is pleased with. This is concerning the angels. What else? The greatest ayah of the Quran. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Who is that who can dare to intercede with him without his permission? And the shafa'ah, inshaAllah, would require us to have a full, not episode, but series of episodes or live broadcasts to speak about the shafa'ah, to learn about the qualities of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and others. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ. That is Allah, the only one who is worthy of worship, your Lord. فَعْبُدُوهُ. So worship him. أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Will you not then take heed and remember? The answer should be, yes indeed, O Allah, we will. We will نَتَذَكَّرْ, and pay attention and ponder over your verses, and we renew our covenant with you. And we say by the end, اللهم أنت ربنا لا إله إلا أنت خلقتنا ونحن عبيدك ونحن على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعنا نعوذ بك من شر ما صنعنا نبوء لك بنعمتك علينا ونبوء بذنوبنا فاغفر لنا فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. Brothers and sisters, it was great to spend this very precious time with you. And until next time, I leave you in the care of Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.